Filipino death row convict Mary Jane Veloso reunited with her family in Indonesia after 5 years. Migrante International says Veloso's parents and two sons traveled to Yogyakarta early last week to visit Mary Jane at her detention in Wonosari. Joining us now to tell us more about the reunion as well as continued efforts to seek a pardon for Veloso are Migrante International Chairperson Joanna Concepcion and Attorney Mini Lopez of the National Union of People's Lawyers. Joanna, Attorney Mini, good morning. Welcome to the program.
Good morning, Mike.
Good morning,
Mike. All right. Now, Joanna, let me start with you. How was the reunion? What was the reaction of Mary Jane when she finally saw her family after 5 years?
Well, of course, it was a joyous occasion. The reunion was something to be celebrated. They haven't seen each other for 5 years since 2018. Mary Jane's two sons, binata na po sila. Kaya nagulat si Mary Jane ang tangkad-tangkad na ng mga anak niya. At sa tuwang-tuwa po siya no, na nakasama na niya po ulit yung kanyang magulang at ang kanyang dalawang anak. And they were able to spend, even though it was a very short time, 2 days, June 12 to 13, they were able to spend almost the whole day together, to eat together, to pray, as well as they were able to attend mass together. And they were able to see Mary Jane do all of her activities inside prison, play the guitar, and Mary Jane showed the batik that she makes inside, and also she plays the drums and all of the poems that she writes. So tuwan-tuwa yung pamilya na makita po muli, mayakap po muli nila ang kanilang anak at ina.
How long was the visit, Joanna? How many hours did it take for them to get together?
The visit lasted for about 2 days. For the first day, I believe they arrived in prison 9 a.m. and then the visit lasted up until 3 p.m. or so. The second day, we arrived there much earlier, about 8 a.m. And then the family left about 4 p.m.
Attorney Mini, how was Mary Jane though? I mean, I understand she's going through some medical concerns. Was it readily apparent during your meeting with her?
Physically, Mary Jane is okay. She underwent surgery a few months ago, I believe, but she's doing okay.
Mm-hmm. There are reports, Attorney Mini, that the cyst actually came back and she needed to be operated again. And there are supposedly concerns about her coughing. Any indication, though, that she might need some medication or does it need hospitalization, though?
I am not quite sure about the need for hospitalization, but I believe that there are request was made to have her checked by medical doctors.
Joanna, why did this visit take 5 years in the making? I mean, how difficult was the process that you had to go through just to make this happen?
Well, Attorney Mike, of course, the pandemic was one factor for the delay of the visit, but also the amount of resources that it would take for the family to be able to visit. Migrante and the family appealed to the Commission on Human Rights, CHR, for assistance to also facilitate the visit. And CHR assisted us in communicating with the DFA, Office of the Undersecretary for Migrant Workers Affairs, to then communicate with the Philippine Embassy, our Philippine Embassy in Jakarta, who would then communicate this request to the Indonesian authorities. And from the Indonesian authorities, it would have to then go through several offices and agencies, as I understand. And the last approval would have to come from the prosecutor's office in Yogyakarta, as well as the correctional institution where Mary Jane is staying.
Mm-hmm. Attorney Mini, Mary Jane has been in jail for 13 years. What's the status of her case legally? We understand that she's been at least saved from the death row a few years back, but what has happened to efforts from the Philippine government to say, ask for commutation, pardon or executive clemency? What are you hearing from your end?
Yes, actually, there is still a pending case before the RTC of Balok in Nueva Ecija. This is the case filed by the Veloso family against Christina Serio and La Canilao for qualified human trafficking, staffa, and illegal recruitment. This case is still pending, no, because of the incident regarding the taking of Mary Jane's deposition, which the Supreme Court allowed in a decision that has become final in 2019. So as far as I know, there is an ongoing discussion between the representatives of the Philippine government and the Indonesian authorities regarding the conditions for the taking of Mary Jane's deposition by written interrogatories.
I understand that one of the reasons why she was saved from death row was because of this case, because the Philippine government argued that she needed to testify against her recruiters. Is there any indication, Attorney Mini, that once she's able to do so, once she's able to make that deposition, and if supposedly the recruiters are convicted, is there an indication that the Indonesian government will more likely grant petitions for her commutation or pardon or executive clemency if it is proven that she really is a victim in this whole ordeal?
We are hopeful that her testimony can affect any humanitarian gestures that the Indonesian government may grant to ensure her freedom. But nonetheless, ongoing efforts by advocates for her release are also important in ensuring that Mary Jane will come home or go home safely to her family eventually.
Mm-hmm. Are you satisfied so far with the efforts by the Marcos administration in trying to bring her back, in trying to get her a pardon or executive clemency? What's the status of that?
I'm not at liberty, I think, to speak on the updates of the ongoing discussions between Philippine authorities and the Indonesian authorities regarding Mary Jane's case. However, of course, there's still more needed to be done. No, so sana yung government would exert all its efforts or all the necessary efforts under its power to ensure na makauwi talaga si Mary Jane safely dito sa Pilipinas at sa kanyang pamilya.
Joanna, there was an issue before about President Marcos offering perhaps to the Indonesian government for Mary Jane to just continue serving time in jail here in the Philippines. Is that something that your organization will support if ever it comes to that?
Well, no. I believe he mentioned the word extradite or extradition. For us, our call continues to be appeal for clemency, no? As Mary Jane is a victim of human trafficking. She is not a criminal and does not belong to any drug syndicate. So that continues to be our stand, and that should be what the president should assert, no? And proactively persist in appealing to the Indonesian president for clemency for Mary Jane as a victim of human trafficking. The case, ongoing case in the Philippines has been 8 years now. Sobrang tagal na, nasa na po yung hustisya para kay Mary Jane bilang biktima ng human trafficking. Kaya meron din pong magagawa ang Pangulo, no, na pabilisin din po sana yung proseso ng pagkuha ng testimonya ni Mary Jane, dahil pag nung binisita po namin yung mga government institutions in Indonesia, that is one of the top questions that they have. Kamusta na daw po yung legal case against Mary Jane's human traffickers in the Philippines, no? Because that is one of the legal basis for them to also grant clemency. So dapat po mainam na pabilisin na po yung proseso dito sa Pilipinas as one way to ensure Mary Jane would also be granted, no, clemency and protection.
And why is Mary Jane's case so important for all other OFWs who might be facing the death row? I mean, the symbolic effect of Mary Jane's incarceration and efforts to save her. How important is that to other Filipinos around the world who may be also facing death row?
Well, of course, the Mary Jane's case is a historic one. It really mobilized thousands of people, not just in the Philippines, but globally, and not just among Filipino migrants, but other migrant nationalities all over the world who really related to Mary Jane's case, the vulnerabilities of women migrants in particular who become targets of human trafficking. And it's very courageous, the courage and the bravery shown by Mary Jane herself, as well as her family to stand up for their rights, also gives a good example for many victims of human trafficking and their families to also assert their rights and speak up.
Mm-hmm. Attorney Mini, the UAE recently pardoned three Filipinos, two of whom were on death row due to drug trafficking. It's a similar case to Mary Jane. Are you optimistic that this could also happen to Mary Jane?
Yes, we are hopeful, no? Hindi tayo pwedeng mawawalan ng pag-asa, no? So we are always hopeful that the Indonesian government will consider any actions or gestures that would ensure or lead to Mary Jane's freedom as well.
Mm-hmm. And Joanna, beyond the 13 years in jail, the toll on Mary Jane's ordeal on the family, how has this affected her sons, her parents, seeing the reunion that happened? You might have observed how the sons were on the trip back away from the jail. How would you describe how the family felt after the visit to Mary Jane?
Actually, Attorney Mike, it was painful. The last day, the second day of the visit, it was the two sons, I think, when they were waving goodbye to their mother. Mary Jane ran to the window and peeked through the window to try to wave at her two sons and also all of us, all who visited. But mostly looking at her two sons, no, it was very painful for them to say goodbye. The two sons shared how much this had the long time that they've been separated has impacted them personally, also has impacted their growth and development as young men. To be away from their mother, and they've gone through many painful journeys. One of the sons shared with us that nawalan siya ng gana na pumasok sa school, nakaka-experience siya ng bullying sa school, or hindi na niya alam kung ano yung direksyon niya sa buhay, kinakailangan ng gabay ng kanyang ina. So of course this really has impacted the children, but nevertheless, Mary Jane, despite being far away, has really been, according to her sons, been able to keep strong for the family and be able to provide the guidance and the nurturing and the love, even through being far away from her family.
How old are the kids now? And how old were they when Mary Jane was first incarcerated?
Well, Mary Jane's youngest son was 1 year old and 3 months when she was incarcerated. The eldest, I believe, was 7 years old. And now the eldest is 20 years old and the youngest is 14 years old.
Mm, so all those years spent away from the mother. Attorney Mini, what message do you have for the Philippine government on behalf of your client, on behalf of Mary Jane, and on behalf of the family who are seeking or yearning for her to come home?
Yes. Sana ma-exert na, no, lahat ng efforts from the Philippine government to facilitate the technical incidents, no, which are pending before the courts. One of which is, where will Mary Jane's testimony be taken, whether it be inside the detention facility or at the Philippine Embassy in Jakarta, in order for her to allow her to deliver her testimony in court and eventually speak her truth. No, I believe that this will greatly, legally in the Philippines, have an impact on her case that she is a victim of human trafficking. And secondly, sana magkaroon talaga ng protection. Hindi lang si Mary Jane, ano, kundi lahat ng ating mga migrant workers, no, na biktima at nagiging biktima who have fallen prey or victims to human trafficking.
And final word to you, Joanna.
Yes, we continue to appeal for clemency for Mary Jane, and the immediate freedom for Mary Jane should be secured at the soonest time possible. Her family wants to bring her home. It's been 13 years, and we hope that the Philippine president, as well as the Marcos administration, continues to advocate, be proactive in advocate for Mary Jane's clemency as a victim of human trafficking. When we visited Mike in Indonesia, the family also had an opportunity to visit many advocates and supporters, faith leaders, and government institutions in Indonesia. Many of them have affirmed and reaffirmed their support for Mary Jane, who also they also want to appeal for clemency for Mary Jane to their president. And so we also call on the Filipino people, Filipino migrants all over the world, to continue supporting Mary Jane and her family, to continue to call to appeal for clemency for Mary Jane.
All right. On that note, thank you so much for joining us this morning, Joanna Concepcion of Migrante International and Attorney Minnie Lopez of the National Union of People's Lawyers.
Thank you.
Thank you.